for joining me. I'm Arielle, and for the next few minutes, I'll demonstrate how to create a basic resume using a template on Google Docs. Crafting a resume can be intimidating, especially if technology has changed since you last created one. But it doesn't have to be. Google provides an accessible way to create a resume without having to buy software or use a resume-generating website that will collect your information for free but won't release a resume to you without payment. All right, let's get into it. You'll need a Google account to access Google Drive. If you don't already have one, you can create one at accounts.google.com/signup. Once you're signed in, head to the Apps section at the top of the page here and select Google Drive. Google Drive is a platform that can be widely used for sharing and creating content. And today, we're just going to focus on Google Docs. There are a few ways to find the resume templates within Google Docs. The first is by selecting New within Drive, selecting the arrow next to Google Docs, and clicking on From a Template. This brings you in to the template gallery, where you'll see your resume templates right at the top of the screen here. If you found you're already in a blank Google document, there are two ways to access the template gallery. One way is by selecting Docs Home, that's this blue little sheet of paper up at the top left of your screen, and selecting Template Gallery. Finally, you can select File, New, and From Template, and here we are again in the same place. These are the five basic resume templates within Google Docs. And you can choose whichever one works best for you and your circumstances. Today, we're going to take a look at Serif. If you've ever used Microsoft Word, you'll notice that the ribbon and tabs at the top of your Google Doc are very similar. One key difference to note is that with Google Docs, you don't have to save your document manually. As long as you remain connected to the internet, Google will automatically save your work to Google Drive. You can check the status of the document by clicking on the cloud at the top here. It should say all changes saved to Drive. If not, check your internet connection. Another difference is naming your document. Because you don't have to manually save it, all you have to do is click to the left in this box here and put in the name that you want. We'll say My Resume. Now let's practice inputting your information into the template. To keep the given formatting consistent, you can either highlight the text and then type your information, or you can delete it. Either way, the formatting stays the same. Just use whichever method works best for you and continue the process throughout the entire document. If the sections in the template don't align exactly with what you want, you can make some quick and easy changes. The great thing about using a template is that it does the advanced formatting work for you, so you can focus on the content and aesthetics. Let's say you only want to add one school. Simply highlight the second school section and delete it. Maybe you want to add a fourth job to the experience section. Again, highlight one of the sections and just copy and paste it beneath. To copy, right-click and select Copy, or select Copy from the Edit tab. To paste, select Paste again by right-clicking or from the Edit tab. There we go. Maybe blue isn't your color. This is easily changed by highlighting the text, selecting the underlined A on your ribbon, and choosing a color that you like. The same goes for font. Just navigate to the font options up here and repeat the process as needed. Generally, when submitting your resume to a website or attaching it to an email, you'll want it in PDF form. To download your resume in any format, just select File, Download, and choose the format you want. This will not alter the Google Doc, which will auto-save and remain in Google Drive so you can access it whenever you want to update your resume. And those are the basics of creating a resume from a template in Google Docs. Check out our website, bcpl.info, to find more videos and virtual programs. And if you have workforce or technology questions or want to know about anything library related, You can connect with us by clicking on the Services tab and selecting Ask a Librarian. Thanks so much for joining us, and we look forward to connecting again soon.